I think that analogies that you use, a machine, a car, our daily maintenance is just like that in recovery. I mean, we have to have these analogies put into place, and we want to communicate these analogies to really explain and really to see the depth of, what am I doing here in sobriety? What am I doing here in recovery? Are there things that I really do need to employ on a daily basis? My cell phone, that's a perfect example. Cell phone works perfectly fine until that red battery starts flashing. And I know at that moment in time, I need to get it to a charger. Same thing with me. When my red battery light starts flashing, I can feel it and I can see it internally. I know at this point, I need to either check a prayer, call another dude to do something outside of myself, because my red battery is flashing.
Yeah.
And that's the analogy that I was able to attach to understand, what is this recovery sustaining all about? What do I have to do? Well, like I said, that battery or that cell phone works perfectly fine until that juice is out. And as a human, my juice runs out.
Yeah.
My patience, my tolerance, my ability to interact with others, sometimes that actually runs thin. So again, when that happens, I know how to recognize it as, hey, there's a red light right there. I can see red lights, and I know, hey, I need to maybe a third step real quick, or maybe call one of my sponsees. And again, that allows me to recharge, reset, and again, that's just how I work it. That's the analogy I needed.
For sure.
It's a great point to talk about the warning signs, because there are warning signs that maybe we're not doing enough, right? Like there's not, like maybe like we get thrown these signs throughout each day, or maybe, on a weekly basis or whenever, we can see very clearly I'm not doing something. Like I know that if I'm interacting with somebody and I don't react the way that I generally know that I have the skills and ability to act, like I'm short, like I'm snarky.
Totally.
I'd say some sarcastic ass comment because that's just who I am. Like, I know that I'm missing something. I know that I'm not doing something. Like, I know that I need to analyze that situation again and say, okay, like, do I owe that person an amends?
God,
like,
damn it.
And sometimes I do,
And that's a 10 step, which that spot check. And again, that's the application, like Marty was saying, with the steps. And that's how we're living 10, 11, and 12. Mm-hmm. That spot check throughout the day, not just at the night. My spot check when I'm wrong, not if I'm wrong, right? I'm probably going to, and when I'm wrong doesn't necessarily mean to you. I could be wrong towards myself. Yeah. That's self-pity or dishonesty. That stuff kicks in, and I got to be able to see it and call it. That's a step 10 right there. Step 11 says, hey, God, can you help me out over here? Redirect me, re-guide me. And that's a step 11. And then 12 kicks in. I could turn my attention to help someone else. And that's textbook, just like that. And I'm wrong. God, can you help me? Find somebody else to help. That's the textbook right there.
Boom.